Beyond giving folks a tax cut, the Obama team has been pushing for this second economic stimulus package, something the president appears to oppose. So where does this idea go now? Joining me now is New Jersey Congressman Scott Garrett. He serves on both the House Financial Services and the Budget Committees. Congressman, great to see you.
It's good to be with you. Thanks.
The University of Michigan economists studied the first stimulus package. They concluded it didn't work. People were mostly not spending it as proposed, but saving their money.
Right.
What about this second stimulus package that would be different? Three things: job creation, extended food stamps, and unemployment benefits. Would that do any good?
Probably not, and for the same reasons that the first stimulus was a failure, and that is, where are you getting the money from? You're just taking it out of the private sector system and putting it into the public sector. You know, I sit here very optimistic about our new president and all the things that he campaigned on and what he wants to bring to Washington. And first and foremost about that is change. And I think that Washington needs change too. And really, if we're going to have change, then you don't go back to the old system, which is stimulus packages, spending more money. The Democrats gave us, I think it's around a $700 billion deficit that we're in the 110th Congress.
Sure.
So if he really wants to give us change, which is why people elected him, then let's go in a new direction and let's not go back to the failed policies of the past.
Well, and you're not the Lone Ranger, because there are a whole host of economists who think that yet another stimulus package is a bad idea. Here's what one of them said, University of Mississippi. He's a senior fellow. The Independent Institute. I'll quote him here. The private economy produces $13 trillion worth of goods and services, so $150 billion is merely chump change. It cannot have any long-lasting effect on economic growth or any other aspect of our crisis economy. Is he right about that?
Absolutely. And if you look at some of the charts, and I don't have little charts here with me, but if I had little charts, I'd be able to show you that when the last stimulus went through, there was a little blip, a little tiny uptick in the third quarter of the year when people began to get those stimulus checks and went out and started buying things. A lot of that money went into savings accounts, so that didn't help, or pay off last old bills, that didn't help. And the same thing's really going to happen no matter how you recoach or how you change the terminology in this. You know, you said job creation. Well, what is that? They're talking about putting money into infrastructure. Well, we know the facts on how infrastructure works. We'll pass the bill tomorrow, and then a year or two from now, those dollars will actually get out the door and start going into projects. So you won't see any.
And during the New Deal, it actually, I mean, history will reflect that it actually was counterproductive, taking jobs away from the private sector. But look, Ben Bernanke has said, I'll sign on to a stimulus deal on one condition, that a lot of it is directed to the credit markets to give improve credit to borrowers, from homeowners to businesses and so forth. What do you think of that?
Well, that's the interesting idea about it, and that would run counter to what we're hearing coming out from the Democrat side of the aisle, that is to take money out of the marketplace, take out of, you know, what the banks need right now is liquidity in the marketplace. And if you're taking money out of it, making the cost of borrowing even higher, then your local small business that wants to expand, that wants to create more jobs and that sort of thing, he's going to have a harder time doing it if you go the tried and true method that we've seen in the last couple years. So Bernanke might be on the right track here, although I would give this caveat to it, that once again, if you put more money into that, we may see, as your prior story says, just when you draw the line and stop pouring more money into the system.
All right. Representative Scott Garrett, as always, good to see you.
Thank you. Appreciate the chance to be with you.